us.
And we'll have the debut, folks. Are you ready for this, Gorilla? Of Fantasio.
Fantasio?
That's what I said. He'll be here this week for the very first time.
Take a look at these two beauties. They will be lumberjacks that will be surrounding the ring in Nashville, Tennessee, hand-picked by Psycho Sid. And, hey, it's right up their alley, Jim Ross. It's sort of like King of the Hill for them.
Man, you're not kidding. They grew up in that type of environment. Maybe DiBiase will pay them enough money to get them a haircut and a shave. Uncle Zeb could use one, too, for that matter.
I understand that they are hoping, Jim Ross, that the Allied Powers defeat Yokozuna and Owen Hart at the In Your House because they want another crack at him.
Well, I'll tell you what, that's a good tag team matchup, no doubt about it. And hard contact is what you're going to find when you see the blue twins in action, Jacob and Eli. We don't know the identical twins apart. We can't tell them apart, I should say.
Well, that's a big plus for them.
Yeah, it certainly is. I don't know if it's Jacob or Eli. Both of them are in the ring right now. We could be pretty conclusive there. But right there, we don't know if that's Jacob or Eli, be that as it may. Anytime you get a chance, hard clothesline, to see this tag team in action, don't you miss it, because I tell you something, they very quietly in many arenas around this world have amassed a great winning percentage. This is a fine tag team combination under the tutelage of Uncle Zebekiah.
Well, they certainly are. Of course, they were sort of humiliated at WrestleMania 11, suffering that loss at the hands of the Allied Powers, but, you know, those kind of things happen.
Yeah, and that match, quite frankly, Gorilla, could have gone either way at several points in the contest.
No question.
And this team has gotten much, much better. They've really improved.
Ooh, look at that power display there.
A lot of power. You got to remember, these guys are about 6 feet eight, maybe 6 feet 9 inches tall, approximately 320 pounds. You can't tell them apart, and it really causes some problems, not only for the opponents, but for the officials as well.
No question about it. Referee, whenever these guys are in there, certainly has his hands full. Look out here. Oh, elbow right in the kisser.
Well, they're not going to out-finesse you, that's for sure. And good flexibility there. That big, probably about a size 15 right in the chest.
At least.
Another tag right there. You got to wonder, you know, with 30 men surrounding the ring, what concerns me about the WWF Championship at In Your House, Gorilla, is one referee, to my knowledge, oh my, one referee is going to be assigned this matchup. So not only does one referee have to watch Diesel and Psycho Sid, but he's got to keep his eye on 31 people.
Right. 31, that's impossible.
Including the Million Dollar Man, the 30 Lumberjacks and the Million Dollar
Man. That's impossible, Jim Ross. Of course, it's understood that the Lumberjack's job is just to throw the guys back in should they try to leave or be thrown out of the ring, but you know. Oh, look at this. Oh, awesome power display. You know, Jim Ross, that some of these guys are going to get physically involved.
Tremendous knee drop right to the chest and the lateral press. And the Jacob and Eli blue tandem, winners, the identical twins, indeed will be at ringside. And you got to think about it, folks. What's going to happen when one referee's got to keep his eye on that many people? Gorilla, as you said, it can't be done.
Well, these guys are very excited about Nashville. And you know, whenever the opportunity presents itself, they're going to get physically involved.
Well, the Million Dollar Man has spent a lot of money stocking the shelves with the best lumberjacks that money can buy. Sid doesn't care how he wins the title, just as long as he wins it, as we take you to the news.